What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to another video. Before we jump into it, I just want to state that this does contain major spoilers for the upcoming Scream 5 film. This is the continuation that we are covering all of the spoilers for Scream 5. I know many of you want nothing to do with Scream 5 and spoilers, so I completely understand if you want to click away. I would ask, before you go, hit that like button. Helps out the channel, helps get this out to people that don't mind spoilers. And if you're still here, 3, 2, 1. All right, hit that like button, helps me out a lot, lets me know you enjoy these types of videos, and I truly appreciate it. If you're not subscribed to the channel, what are you doing? Hit that subscribe button, follow by the bell notifications, stay up to date with all things Scream, join this wonderful community and all of our discussions, and let's get into it. So I'm gonna read the point, and then we will have a discussion per usual, so let's jump right into it. More on Sam and Hank. Hank was a serial womanizer, and Tara, Sam's mom, was dating him while also dating Tara's father, Sam's assumed father. It wasn't hard for her to hide Sam's paternity. Now, if you've been following along on all of these points, then you know what the main twist for Scream 5 is, and that is that Sam is Billy Loomis's sister. Hank, Billy Loomis's father, you may have seen him in 96, Scream 96, that he was a womanizer. Obviously, we know the story of him sleeping around with Maureen, but that was the most public because of the murder and everything surrounding that, that was essentially the catalyst for Mrs. Loomis leaving and all of that. And in many ways, Hank Loomis is the catalyst for this entire franchise, really, because he was the one that stepped out on Mrs. Loomis to sleep with Maureen. Billy saw what was going on through Roman and then decided to take out Maureen. That sparked the controversy and all the discussion and news coverage and all that, which caused Mrs. Loomis to leave, and then Billy executed on the Woodsboro killings. So it was just like this full circle moment in the 96 classic. So that will be hopefully explored more in this Scream 5 film, because obviously the main twist is that Hank is the father of Sam Carpenter, the focus character. We know, again, if you've been following along, you know that she is the new final girl, that she is the one that gets transitioned. And so it makes a ton of sense, and hopefully they elaborate and really dive in to that story. Hopefully through flashbacks or whatever the case may be, hopefully we get sort of a peek behind the curtain as far as how that all unfolded. Now, obviously, the mother, she is going to play a major role in this film as well. The spoilers also stated that she is sort of in the Neil Prescott type role. You know, so she goes on a business trip, the mother ends up missing, and, you know, Neil Prescott. And so, to be honest, I can actually see it being a mixture of 96 and Scream 3. And what I mean by that, you have the sort of Neil Prescott and the mother of Sam. Now, the whole story and the whole killings are centered around Sam and this sort of twist. So Sam's mother gets kidnapped, just like Neil Prescott, and then very likely at the end will be the big reveal. Now, the reason this is would be reminiscent of Scream 3 as well is because Roman with Milton, at the end, he brings out Milton and says that he is the cause for everything. He's the cause of all your suffering, all your pain. You know, don't you wish you could kill him, basically. And I could see something very similar arising in the upcoming Scream 5 film. You know, the killer, whoever it may be, pulls out the mother. You know, it's clear that they're not trying to set her up, because the whole time they're trying to set up Sam as Ghostface. So the mother is just sort of a casualty. So it's very likely that they're going to pull her out and say, you know, she's the whole reason this is happening. She's lied to you. She was, you know, whatever, and promiscuous and running around. And this is why this is happening. So I could see that sort of full circle, those little subtle nods to the past films, which we're supposed to get. Like we've talked about, a lot of these scenes are going to be very similar and reminiscent. Not really a like for like, but in if you are familiar with the past films, you're going to have scenes where you're like, ah, okay, I get that. Like that's this scene, you know, even the opening scene. Very reminiscent of Casey Becker in the original Scream. So you're going to get a lot of those very mirroring type scenes, so this would make a lot of sense. Now, hopefully we get a backstory in regards to the mother, and it's not just like, oh yeah, she was, you know, promiscuous running around behind the father's back type thing. Hopefully we get some elaboration. Same thing with Hank. Whether Hank will be a fixture character in this film, I'm not sure about that. But you would imagine that they're going to go really in depth in this. I'm sure it's not going to be like, oh, here's 30 minutes of the film, here's the twist, and we just won't even, like, here, you get what you get. I would assume that there's going to be a whole, you know, spiderweb effect of the overall story, and we're going to get a ton of information in regards to Hank, the mother, that affair, all of that stuff. And so it also states that it was really easy for the mother to hide Sam's pregnancy, which right off the bat makes a ton of sense. So she was dating Tara's father at the same time. Now, we also know that she became pregnant right before the actual killings of Billy Loomis. And the reason she wanted to keep it quiet was because those killings happened and she wanted to protect the baby and keep things under wraps. Makes perfect sense, given that, you know, if your affair or your secret love child is really the brother of a serial killer, and all the media and all the coverage and all the madness surrounding that, it's very likely you're going to keep that under wraps, especially when you're dating another man and he's oblivious to it. You know, as far, and unless the mother was, you know, very promiscuous, it's very likely that she was, it would make more sense that she would be a sort of, you know, girl next door type woman, just like her daughters, but had this like deep dark secret. You know, we all have our secrets, so to speak. So they have like this deep dark secret, and so the father was oblivious to it because he had no reason to question it or doubt it. They were dating, they were likely sleeping together. So she becomes pregnant with Sam. She's like, hey, this is your baby. And he thinks nonetheless, he's like, I'm a father now, I'm excited, this is great. I get to, you know, have my first daughter, carry on this, my legacy, so to speak. You know, what most fathers do. You know, that's how I was when I got my first father. I was thrilled. Or my first child, I was thrilled, you know. It's that excitement. And so it's very likely nothing was really thought about. It would have been really easy for the mother to hide it because no one would have questioned it. No one would have thought anything else. And so you just keep that secret buried away. You end up having Tara a couple years later, and so that makes perfect sense. And the father just thinks, you know, oh, I got two daughters now. And that's the sort of gist of that. So it makes a ton of sense that it would be easy to sort of mask behind this facade and just keep that a secret. And then eventually it just becomes, you know, that is his daughter and that is whatever it is. It'll be interesting to see what has happened to the father, like the Tara's father, you know, Sam's supposed father or believed to be father, because there is no mention at this time of him. The only thing we have a mention of is the mother. So I'm curious to see how that unfolds. Obviously, Sam, she leaves because of whatever tension and what is going on in that home, whether the father is involved or perhaps the father passed away, and that's what sort of led this tension and this pool between the mother and the children that led Sam to leave. I'm really curious to see how that unfolds. I think that would be a very likely and believable approach. But again, hopefully we get a broad rundown of everything unfolding, because I'm a personal fan of this theory. I really love the sort of twist and idea, and I think it makes a ton of sense. It's a great full circle moment. I've mentioned it in the past, and we know that this film is centered around the Carpenter sisters. I mean, even just the synopsis is clearly about them. We know quite a bit about their relationship and that dynamic and that story and what it's centered around, how Tara sort of built up as this, you know, final girl, but it later transitions to Sam. And I'm curious to see how that will tie into Sydney, because Sydney, obviously, from the jump, has no ties to Sam. Sydney is outside of Woodsboro. Sam lived in Woodsboro. Sam moved somewhere else. It's very unlikely that they connected with each other, because Sydney was isolated. And as far as we know, as far as the information that we have, it appears that Sydney's still at that house from Scream 3. So she's isolated, she's away from everybody, she probably just goes randomly into town, stuff like that. So she might not even be aware of Billy having a sister. And it sort of is evident based on some of the spoilers. Now, because there is a sort of come to realization moment, and then Sydney is forced to make a decision. because she has to make a decision regarding Sam. Do I save her or do I let her die and risk my own life trying to save her? And it would make sense because it says that Sydney's very like resistant. She's very like, want to keep your distance. And so if that's the case, it would make sense that she is aware, or maybe not from the jump. Maybe she didn't know from the beginning, but as she returns to Woodsboro, everything unfolds. Maybe that evidence comes to light and she knows like, hey, this is Billy's sister. And she's would immediately be reluctant. She'd immediately want to kind of keep her distance and stay away because you don't know. Like, what if that runs in the family? You know, you had Billy, her mother, the father is a corrupt lawyer and just kind of like a sleazeball. So, you know, I don't want to be close or tied to her. So it would make sense. And then obviously we know that she makes the decision. She goes with her gut and saves Sam. And that sort of foils Ghostface's plan. And then they have to sort of pivot and change direction. And then that's how the story will likely end on that sort of change, the final act and so on and so forth. But overall, it's really fascinating to see this sort of transition. And hopefully we get a ton of explanation and backstory in regards to all of these elements and all of these pieces. So that way the story fits, makes sense, it's fluid. And then obviously Sam is the one that there's a passing of the torch moment between Sydney and Sam. And that makes sense because again, they're trying to get away from the OG3. This is likely their last film. So you're going to see that transition, Sam step into the final girl role and then take on Ghostface. Whether Sydney has a hand in that or not is yet to be seen. We'll likely find out when the film comes out. But overall, it's a nice little package, I think. But as always, I want to hear from you. This is a discussion. Let me know down in the comments what you think. Do you like this idea? Do you not like this idea? Do you want a very elaborate, in-depth moment for this overall plot twist? Or just give us a quick, brief rundown. We can pick it up. We can understand it. And then just get to the point. I'd love to know either way down in the comments below. If you haven't liked this video, hit that like button. It helps me out a lot. Lets me know you enjoy these types of videos, and I truly appreciate it. If you're not subscribed to the channel, again, what are you doing? Hit that subscribe button, follow up with the bell notifications, stay up to date with all things Scream, join this wonderful community and all of our discussions. I'll see you all in the next one. Thank you.